In this video, I'm going to share with you a product template for merch by Amazon that you can use to see all the different colors of the standard t-shirts that they have. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005, and one of my favorite places to sell online is merch by Amazon. And they have a lot of colors for standard t-shirts, and they actually have product templates that you can use for Photoshop and Illustrator and GIMP even. I'll show you where that is on their site, but they didn't have one for Affinity Designer, and you know that I use Affinity Designer a lot, and I think a lot of you do since watching my videos. So I made this resource from theirs. I'm gonna show you where to find theirs, and then I put it together on Affinity Designer so that you can use it. For those of you that have Affinity Designer, can see all the different colors for the standard t-shirts, and this is a great resource so that you can see if the colors that you made for your design are working on the t-shirt, kind of a preview before actually uploading it. You can see a preview when you upload it too, but by that point it might be a little too late and then you're gonna have to come back and forth. So this one's actually in Affinity Designer, so you can make the changes right there before you upload it and see if they work on the colors. I'll show you what this means and how it works. First, let's get into Merch by Amazon, and I'll show you where the originals are. So here I am on Merch by Amazon. If you sell on Merch by Amazon, you should be very familiar with this page. It's the Create page. This is where you upload your designs to, and you can see all the products. Right now, they only have this many products. We're gonna look at standard t-shirts. So just click on here, Edit Details. And if you scroll down right below the product right here, you can see Get Product Templates. Now this works here, like I said, when you come in here and you put in your design, you can see a preview, but it's small. You're gonna have to zoom in unless you have really good eyes, and you can see kind of a preview of it. What the product template does is actually help you when you're creating your product, your design, to see it right there instead of waiting to come in here and seeing, oh, those colors don't work, I'm gonna have to go back and change it, right? So click on Get Product Templates, and it's gonna open a new tab, and this is where you see all the product templates that Merch by Amazon has. It's been here a while. I think they just gave you a better access to find it there. And then you can see here, if you scroll down, these downloads includes all the products for this size, 4,500 by 5,400. In Photoshop, they also have one just for t-shirts. They have one for art size only, and then Illustrator version and a GIMP version. The Illustrator version didn't work in Affinity Designer, which is why I wanted to make it in Affinity Designer, because I use that. The Photoshop version worked in Affinity Photo, so if you have that, you can download that and use it. And let's see, they also have product templates for the bigger sizes, the hoodies. You can see here, Photoshop, Illustrator, GIMP again, and pop sockets, and phones, and pillows, and tote bags. So you can see here all of those. So all of those are great, and then these are just the sizes, right, of them that we know already. So I'll show you what it looks like. It looks a little different in the Adobe Photo version because that's from them. It's gonna have some branding, also some text to help you out. The one I made in Affinity Designer is very basic, just the shirts and things. So I'll show you the difference. So I'm gonna download the Adobe Photoshop version, and I'm gonna show you what it looks like in Affinity Photo first, so you can see what it comes with. And then I'll open up the one I made in Affinity Designer and show you how I changed it just a little bit. So here I am in Affinity Photo, so a little different than Affinity Designer. It looks very similar if you've never used Affinity Photo. It's nice to have this sometimes to do some work. And you can see the tools look very similar and the layers and it's all. So if you're familiar with Affinity Designer, Affinity Photo's really nice too if you like using Photoshop. So here's their branding, Merch by Amazon, place your design in here, previews, t-shirt types, submit your design, right? So you can put your design right here, and you can see you can turn things on and off. So they had these right here. I don't know why they included that, but it's turned off by default. And then if you turn this off, you can see that's the whole t-shirt, and this is the back of the t-shirt, which I didn't include. So I'm gonna turn this off here. I'm gonna expand this, and you can see you can turn off the guides. That's where your shirt design would go right here. Place your design here. And then of course you'd want to turn off that guide to see it and turn off everything. So let's say you have your design right here and you can go through and, you know, change the color. So each one of these are named. So you can see, does it look good on the brown t-shirt? Does it look good on the cranberry t-shirt or the dark heather? They're all here, which is really nice. So you don't have to worry about knowing what the colors are and things like that. They just have it. And what I like about this is that you get the texture as well. So on the heather ones, you get the texture to kind of see that. That's hard to do with just a solid color. But yeah, they're all here. The heather gray too, that's kind of hard to do just with a solid color. So you would put your design here into either Adobe Photoshop if that's what you opened it up in, or Affinity Photo in this case, put it here. And the same would work, I'm guessing, for the Illustrator version. It would look very similar. I didn't download that because I couldn't open it. And the GIMP version probably looks very similar. So this is Merch by Amazon's version of it. I'm gonna show you what I did in Affinity Photo. I didn't need to put all this stuff in here. I mean, I could if that's helpful, but I think when I explain it, you'll see what it does. Really easily. So let's go into the Affinity Designer version that I made to help you out. So here we are in Affinity Designer. This is the one I made. I added this right here. So let's say you have a design and you built your design here. I made this 4500 by 5400, which is the Merch by Amazon size. So you'll have this artboard in it and then make your design however you want. You can see this one, I added a lot of colors. So I want to make sure that they work on the t-shirt. So this is what kind of an example. I won't have this for you. This is just one that I designed with lots of colors, and maybe your design has lots of colors too, so you want to test it out on the different t-shirts. So what you would do is create your design here, or put it in here, make sure it's the right size, and then just drag it over here. So to this spot right here. It may be behind, so you're gonna have to move it in the front, move to front here. And you can see right away that these colors don't work on this dark t-shirt, but we can look at all the different colors t-shirts here as well. So click over here on the layers, and then you can turn off that place your design here. That's just a guide. So if you turn that off, you can see without the guide. And then start playing with the different t-shirt colors by turning off the ones above it. So you can see asphalt is first. Doesn't look good on asphalt. Baby blue. Yeah, it looks good on baby blue. That's one. Black. It looks good on black. I think it looks good on black. Brown. Kind of hard to read, I mean, a little bit, so I wouldn't do brown. So blue and black so far. Cranberry, you can see you can't even see that color for monster. It's very hard to see, so I wouldn't pick that one. Dark heather, again, hard to see. Green, and you can go through all of these. Heather gray looks pretty good, so that's three right there. And you want to maximize the amount of t-shirts that you can use, right? So if it only works on two or three, I mean, that would be great if you really love these colors, but if you change the colors and you still like it, you may want to pick that instead. So let me go through some of these. Lemon looks great. You know, that one doesn't. And you get the idea. Some of these, you can't even read the words, right? So what I would do in that case is I would turn it all back on. And this would, what would happen if you already put it on there, you thinking that this is great, you put it on Merch by Amazon, and you go through that little preview and you notice it only works on three or four colors, and you're like, oh no, I want it to work on more colors. You could come in here now instead and change the colors of these. So let's click all these right here. I probably should have grouped these. I'm going to group them now. Command G and make these white, right? White just works on dark t-shirts. And maybe this one, I'm going to select this color, right? And then maybe this one. Actually, I like that color. I'm gonna reverse it. I'm gonna group this one, make that color that. Maybe this one, maybe trucks, white, and monster that color. So I think that looks a lot better now on, especially on this color. So I'm gonna close this up and play with the colors again. On asphalt now, it looks great. So there's one. On blue, not so much. This is only going to work on dark colors since I used light colors here. So, baby blue, but on black, it really pops, right? So, that's a good one. Brown, again, it works. Dark colors. Cranberry, now these starting to work with more colors. You see on the dark heather, it looks great. Green, again. So, I'll be able to use these on a lot of them. Dark blue, heather blue, looks great. This one's kind of iffy. Again, this is a lighter color t-shirt, so it's not going to work with the lighter letters, right? And so on green, looks great, right? Lemon, not so much because it's a light color t-shirt. So you could do both. You could do one for dark t-shirts and one for light t-shirts and see how they work. This is definitely a dark t-shirt design but you can see it looks great on navy and things like that. So just go through all of them and test them out. And then when you're happy with it, you can put it back here. So let's move it back over here and then export it. So just hit this, come over here and export, boom. And then I'll move this export here. And then you just wanna do selection area only and then export. And then you're gonna export it as a PNG. It's gonna be a transparent PNG because it's selection only. And now you can do that in that create tab that we just saw earlier in Merch by Amazon and upload it there. And then you'll know what colors work well for it because you've seen a preview there and everything will be great, right? So that's how you do it for standard. Now they have similar colors on some of the other products, but I may have to do one like this for each product because I know the V-necks have slightly different colors and so on. So if you want that, if you want product templates for all of those, let me know in the comments. I can do that pretty easily and just like I did before, download the Photoshop version and convert it over here. I think it's really helpful. I know the standard shirt had the most colors, and that's why I did standard first, because you can only pick 10 colors for the standard t-shirts, whereas some of the other ones, standard and premium, have the 10 color selection, and the other ones do have that limit, but they only have 10 colors too. So I think it's great to do for standard and premium, and premium is just slightly different colors, so I may want to do a premium as well. So hopefully this video is really helpful for you, and this is something that you'll use for Merch by Amazon. I'll put it on my downloads page. Let me show you where that is. So here's my Detour Shirts page, www.detourshirts.com. And if you go to downloads, I haven't put it there yet, but this is where it's gonna be. Go to downloads and you'll see all the downloads that I have. Most of them are free. Some of these are, you know, just vectors that I've done, but I'm gonna make it free since I didn't make it. I mean, I kind of made it, but I didn't make the original. So I'll put it right around here or maybe right here. And you'll be able to download that, but there's all these other ones that you can download for free as well. I'll put a link in the description of this video where to find it, and it'll be absolutely free, a free download, and you'll be able to use it for Affinity Designer. Again, you can, if you don't have Affinity Designer and you have Photoshop and Illustrator and GIMP or GIMP, you can use the other ones that I showed earlier. So have fun with this. Hopefully this really helps you pick the best colors for your design for each t-shirt in Merch by Amazon. So that is it for this video. Thanks again for watching it. Hopefully this video was super helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, hit that subscribe button. I got one right there. The question of the day for this video is, what are your go-to colors for standard t-shirts on Merch by Amazon, or any t-shirt if you don't sell on Merch by Amazon? What are yours? I like putting my designs on black t-shirts, of course. I love the navy color if it works, and those dark heather ones. Those are my top three favorite colors to put on t-shirts. So let me know in the comments what are yours. I think everybody has just a little bit different selection, whatever works best for them and what they like to wear. So that'd be good to hear in the comments. Thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more videos to help you with your print on demand business, click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.